Hello friends, today we are going to calculate electric field at a point P which are at a distance z between from which distance z there are two charges plus q and they are separated by d distance, and from the midpoint of the d distance it is the midpoint of the distance d. From the midpoint of the distance to the point P there is a distance z, so from the midpoint of the distance to that point P at z distance at a point P, what will be the electric field? So now let's start. You know, electric field due to a point charge is what? Electric field due to point charge is q by 4 pi epsilon naught r square. And direction will be what? Direction will be along this direction. Similarly, due to this q charge, what will be the electric field direction? This will be along this direction. And the value of E2 will be same, q by 4 pi epsilon r square. What is the R? R is the charge to which you are calculating electric field, that is this distance R. Now we have to calculate at a point P. We have named the angle theta, and we have to calculate at this point the resultant electric field. The resultant electric field will be in this direction. And now you always know that if any axis or any component made an angle theta with another things, then the vertical the horizontal component will be cos theta, and the vertical component according to this will be sine theta. So along this, as this making an angle theta, so along this component, what will be the resultant electric field direction? This will be Ez cos theta. So now let us calculate the resultant electric field. So here you are getting same magnitude of E1, same magnitude of E2. So resultant will be what? Q plus 4 pi epsilon naught r square plus 4q by 4 pi epsilon naught r square, E1 plus E2, 2q by 4 pi epsilon naught r square. But here we are taking the horizontal component. Why taking horizontal component? Because it is making an angle theta, and with which the theta is making an angle, this line, this component will be making the cos theta component. So the Ez will be 2q by 4 pi epsilon r square cos theta. Now from the geometry, it is perpendicular. This perpendicular means it distance is z, and this distance is d by 2, as it is cutting at the midpoint d by 2. So what will be the hypotenuse? Hypotenuse is square equals perpendicular square plus base square. Perpendicular distance is z and base is the d by 2 here. So what will be this distance? Perpendicular square, that is z square, plus d by 2 whole square. And what is the cos theta? Cos theta means base by hypotenuse. Base is here what? Base is here z. And hypotenuse is what? Hypotenuse is here r. So cos theta equals z by r. So means z by r cos theta. Now from here you are getting r square. So r equals what? Root over z square plus d by 2 whole square. So cos theta equals z by r. So z by root over z square plus z d by 2 whole square. So putting the values of r and z and cos theta, putting the values of cos theta and r square here, now you will get the electric field will be 2q by 4 pi epsilon naught z square plus d by 2 whole square whole to the power 3 by 2 after calculating. Thank you.